Hello friends, welcome back to the channel. My name is Veronika. Today's video is just a cute, fun haul for Oner Active, which is an athletic apparel clothing brand. I've done one video over them like over a year ago. So it's high time we check out the pieces and see how we feel about them now. Of course, I took advantage of their little Black Friday deal because it was pretty good, not gonna lie. Not sponsored by this brand and they don't know I'm making this video at all. I purchased everything with my own money. In general, I've just always been a fan of Oner Active. I like their pieces. I feel like they're really flattering. So I figured making a video out of my own shopping haul is like killing two birds in one stone, you know what I mean? Unfortunately, by the time this video is up, their Black Friday deal will no longer be active. But when I checked this morning, all of the items I bought were still available, either in different sizes, different colors, or the exact same thing I got. So still worth checking it out if you like anything. But again, this video is just for fun because I'm not affiliated with them in any way at all, unless they wanna be Oner Active. Feel free to hit me up. This clothing rack is looking a little sparse, so let's open this and I'll fill it up in 3, 2, 1. That is a little bit better. So I got 6 different items from Oner Active. 2 leggings, 2 tops, and 2 jackets. One of the tops is definitely for the gym and the other one's more of a lifestyle piece. I didn't want to get too much in this haul, so it's a little bit of a smaller haul, but I definitely wanted some essentials that were in more neutral, basic colors. Things I know I'm gonna wear and get a ton of use out of, so we don't want to be wasteful with our purchases. So very curious as to how I like these items. Here are my measurements for your reference, and of course, as always, they'll be in the description box for you below. Before we get into these pieces, if you're curious, the sports bra I'm wearing right now is their everyday sports bra, and this is in the ice blue color. Had this for a little while. It's definitely cute. I like that it has adjustable straps, and of course the color is just stunning. These are their Effortless shorts that I've had for quite some time. I think they're like one of the red colors. Not too sure what the color is because I've had these shorts for a while, but if it's still on their website, I'll put it somewhere on the screen. This is the fit while we go over things. Still Oner Active, still available on their website. Let's check out some of their pieces. A lot of these I've never tried before, so I'm so excited. I think what I'm gonna do first is do the jackets, then the tops, and then we'll do the leggings last. So let's go ahead and check out this dark blue jacket number. I've never tried this piece and I'm stoked. This is Oner Active's Timeless Crop Jacket, and I got this in a size medium. I am typically a medium in tops and a small in bottom. This is also their true blue color. As of right now, this jacket is available in this color as well as other ones, and it is available in all of their sizes, and it retails for $50. As you can see, this jacket is of course a cropped length, and you do have the long sleeves. There are thumb holes here as well. We love to see it. There is a zipper. There is a full zip, so it's not a half zip moment. Truthfully, I am not a zipper expert, but to me this feels like a good quality zipper. It's not gonna break. I've definitely had jackets in the past from other brands that were flimsy and broke after like 2 uses, but thankfully this one looks promising so far. This zipper actually has an auto lock, so it's not going to move on you. You have to like manually push it up, and that way you can adjust it. But once it's pushed down, there's no budging. I definitely appreciate those little small features and details. Pretty much an eyesore, but you see this huge tag here. You can't actually just cut this short. They are intended to be cut. I don't think anyone wants this uncomfortable mess here. There are some flat seams as well that are meant to contour your body, and you'll see them in the front too. These type of activewear jackets typically are tight on the arms, and I do gain weight in my upper arms, so that's typically why I get a medium. This is a pretty stretchy material, so I'm not too worried about the arms being too tight, to be honest. A little bit of a high neck moment, very cute. Then you also have a monocolored logo right here from Oner Active, which I love to see because I just don't like very obvious, very in your face logos anymore. And the fabric makeup of this top, and I believe most of their items, is 78% polyester and 22% elastane. Let's just go ahead and throw this baby on, tags and all, just in case. Immediately, my arms do not feel suffocating in this at all, which I'm very grateful for because I hate that feeling. It actually almost feels like I could have done a small, not gonna lie. I'm pretty happy I did a medium. I just prefer it to be a little bigger than too small. And truthfully, I'm a medium girl. It's unfortunately a gamble for me no matter what, so it is what it is. This is what it looks like unzipped. Very cute. Giving Pilates girl kind of vibes. I actually feel like I have extra room in the arms. So honestly, if I buy this jacket again, I may actually go for a small. Let's go ahead and zip her up. Of course, again, high neck moment if this is kind of like the look that you're going for. Super cute. I personally like to have it kind of like this. Ready to go on a run, ready to go to Pilates. You know, just the typical hot girl activities. It's so dumb. But I really like it. It's very cute. Like I said, there is a little extra room in the arms, which I think is really great because it shows that they're accounting for that, which is nice because I feel like most of their athletes that promote their athletic apparel are pretty like buff, very much like bodybuilder style girls. So I feel like it's essential to have some extra room for your biceps, your triceps, all of that. And it definitely seems like Oner Active took that into account with this jacket. These shorts are like high-waisted, but my belly button is down here. If you're wearing high-waisted jeans or high-waisted leggings, you're going to have a little bit of a midriff showing. I have a very average size torso. It's not very long. It's not short either. Obviously, if you have a longer than average size torso, you're gonna have more stomach showing, and then vice versa. If you have a shorter torso, probably gonna cover all your skin. This is what it looks like in the back. I am honestly just obsessed. I'm obsessed with this color. And then of course in the front, you have the seams right along the chest, and I do find them flattering. I think they knew what they were doing here. I definitely appreciate how much quality this jacket feels like it has. I can move around it very easily. No problems, no qualms. If I lift my arms, stays in place pretty good, I must say. I'll be getting a lot of use out of this. Just saying. It's just a cute vibe. I'm obsessed. Look at the thumb holes. Adorable. Now let's try this other white jacket here. I actually saw Krissy Cela, who I think is the owner of this company, wear this in one of her gym workout videos. She looked stunning. I was obsessed. I was influenced, and I bought this jacket, and I'm excited. I hope it doesn't let me down. Let's take a look. Ooh, this is definitely gonna show very brightly on camera, but just bear with me. This is their timeless jacket. Obviously, you can see this one is full length, and I got this in the color white, and I also got this in a size medium. I'm looking at it, and especially after wearing this jacket and just seeing the appearance of this, I have a feeling it's gonna be too big for me. We shall see. Maybe it'll form my body. This particular jacket in this color is only available right now in XXL, but they are available in other colors and different sizes. Still worth checking out. I think I remember trying to buy this jacket several months ago and it was sold out, so it's kind of hard to get my hands on, but I was so happy it was available for Black Friday. Let me just clip y'all in here so I have a free hand. This, of course, is still the timeless jacket, so the features are very much the same as this blue one I just tried on. The only difference is that it is full length. There's actually two front pockets in the front. They are very discreet in design. The pocket isn't huge, but it's enough to warm your hands if you need it, or put your keys, a card, some money, etc. You still have the same exact seams in the back as well as the seams in the front. It's a little hard to see in this white color, but I promise it's there. Let's just go ahead and try it on. Previous jacket is off, and we got this baby off the rack. All right, so I have her on. There's definitely some room. Definitely still feel like I could have sized down to a small, but it's not as big as I thought it was going to be. Obviously, it's the same as the blue jacket. It even feels the same, so it feels like the sizing is consistent, considering this is a very light color and that's a dark color. And with dyes and fabrics, that can change the sizing a little bit. This is what it looks like with the jacket open. Now we'll zip it up. Very cute. Full length. Obviously, no skin will be showing with this jacket. And you do have the pockets. The pockets are really small, so don't anticipate carrying a lot in them, but they can still be useful for any small items when you're running or going to the gym. On that same note, on the inside of the jacket, you do have these little folds. So if you want to slip anything inside your jacket, you could definitely do so. And again, I just love the feeling of this jacket. It definitely feels like quality. This is what it looks like in the back. Very cute. We love to see it. There is a little bit of extra room, so if you're in between, I would recommend sizing down. There's still enough room in the arms, which was my own personal main concern. In the front, it might be hard to see on camera, but there's just like a little bit of extra fabric. It's nothing crazy. It doesn't look like I'm drowning in this jacket by any means, so I will be keeping this jacket, but just something to know if you're in between. But if you're only one size, just stick to your true size. You'll be set and good to go. So far, so good with Oner Active. I'm very pleased with these jackets. Let's try on the black athletic top slash sports bra and then the mock neck. Then we'll get to the leggings because I feel like that's like what most people want to see. So let's go ahead and grab that black top. So here we have this adorable, very flattering cut of the Timeless square neck mid vest. I was so excited for this because black is like a staple color and it's slimming. I actually already have this top in another color. They're like lighter brown version and I'm obsessed with it. So for me, Black Friday was the perfect time to grab this piece. Of course, this is the black color and I did get this in a size medium. As of right now, they're available in most sizes, but not a medium, just to be transparent. There are other colors in different sizes as well to check out. This retails for $42 and it is the same fabric as these Timeless jacket pieces, 78% polyester, 22% elastane. Some of the features, of course, as the namesake goes, you do have that square neckline here and it does go up into a halter and then into one single strap in the back. This is a mid crop top, but there is a full on sports bra built into this, so you do not need to wear a sports bra by any means underneath. It has cup pads, everything like that, so you don't have to worry about nippage. Unfortunately, the back is not actually adjustable. The straps are pretty stretchy, but that's definitely a feature I feel like they should incorporate, and this piece is currently lacking. You do have the mono raised logo again here, and since this is black, the logo is gray. In their other colors, it is the same similar color, so it's a very discreet, not in your face by any means. There is one seam on each side at the front here that's meant to help like snatch you just a little bit. Not super noticeable in a black top, but you would see that much more clearly in their lighter color tops. Other than that, that's pretty much all the basis. So let's go ahead and put this baby on. Here is the Timeless square neck mid-length version, and I am obsessed with this top. I feel like I say I'm obsessed with everything. Oner Active pretty much kind of kills it, not gonna lie. This is the perfect top for an upper body day. I love the neckline. It feels elegant, and I like that there's really good side boob coverage. That's a huge ick I have with different tops, is when my side boobs and fat just kind of bulge out. So obsessed with the fact that we don't have that issue here. This is what it looks like in the back. Love the more open back design. My lats feel completely free, not restricted at all. Nothing is digging into them. So I really feel like this is the perfect back day top. I'm super happy with the mid-length as well because sometimes I just don't feel like showing off any kind of skin in my midriff section. If I feel bloated or on my period, I just, a good black top that is more covered is just chef's kiss in those moments. And some people just prefer having more coverage in their tops, and that's totally cool. This could be a really good option for you because you still will get the whole high-waisted effect of your bottoms because it literally hits right at the leggings. Raising my arms, it stays put pretty well, I must say. And it could be hard to see with the camera, but there are seams right here. And in real life, they really do look flattering. They have a way of just making you have that hourglass shape. I do feel like this top was definitely made with women in mind. It's just so cute. I'm obsessed. Also, I've been on a black clothing kick lately, so I'm just very happy to have this top in my collection. I think I'm gonna get the white version of this top as well because if you have a black and white version, it will match with anything. The only negative drawback is slightly the halter being a little tight. I really wish they would make these straps adjustable, but unfortunately they are what they are. So if you're someone with more defined traps or just like more space up here, then you may find that this is just too tight for you. You could size up because I find that this is very like fitting. I do find this part to be just a little bit uncomfortable. It's nothing too crazy. It doesn't dig in too much. I could definitely wear it for one workout. However, if I wore this for like a road trip, I would definitely be uncomfortable over time. And that just comes with the territory with a lot of halters, I think. Definitely recommend sizing up if you're in between anyway, but keep that in mind. You may want to entirely size up even if you're true to size. With that, let's try on their mock neck top, which is another piece I have never tried in my life, and I'm excited to do so today. So let's go grab it. So now we have the Mellow Rib Mock Neck Tank, and this is in their oil blue color. I'm obsessed with this version of blue. This top is actually available in every single size, and as of this morning, this top is still on sale, even though I didn't see anything else on sale. It's probably like $12. So if you're interested, just go ahead and grab it because I feel like that's a pretty good price. Normally, it does retail for $32, so 60% off is pretty good. And they do, of course, sell this in other colors as well. I got this top in a size medium because I just always size up for my tops just in case. I can tell this rib material is extremely, extremely stretchy, so I bet I could have done a small, but we'll go ahead and see how it fits. Some features, of course, the namesake is this mock neck. There aren't any like seams underneath, so it's all cohesive with the tank top. And you can see there are some seams here. Very on brand for Oner Active. They love the contour seams. You can hopefully see that it is a ribbed material. Very, very soft. There is some stitching detail around the armpits as well as at the very bottom. You can just see the little curve here. Just little small details. And then the Oner Active logo is at the very bottom as a tag. Very discreet. You would really not notice it wearing it out and about. The material for this top is 92% rayon and 8% elastane. Very curious how this top is gonna go. Instead of this top, I'm gonna wear my original everyday sports bra underneath because this obviously is not for the gym. It's literally a lifestyle piece. So I'll put on that sports bra and then we'll get this top on. All right, so giving fashion, giving all the sophisticated vibes, and honestly, a win. This is that mellow rib mock neck tank top. This is the full view. I love the bottom of this top. It's very, very flattering. These seams here, I feel like are gorgeous and just such a nice touch to this type of top. And I do have that original sports bra underneath, and yet you can't really tell. These are the details of the mock neck. Very, very elegant and seamless along the whole shirt. This is what it looks like. Honestly, it just feels really, really soft. When I go back into the office next year, I will be utilizing this top a lot. I just feel like this is so cute and just like a staple piece for work, for going out, for going to the grocery store if you want to look a little more sophisticated, whatever. Of course, I'm also obsessed with this color. It's just gorgeous. I love dark blues. This is what it looks like in the back. Very simple, nothing too crazy. I'm just like obsessed with this top, not gonna lie. I feel like the front is just so flattering, waist snatching, even though there's zero compression in this top. I'm so happy this top worked out. It was more of a gamble purchase. Let's go ahead and get into these leggings. I will be showing you the gray version since it's kind of easier to see. And then in an overlay, I'll try on the black version too. They are their Effortless Seamless Leggings, which is their most popular leggings. And I own several colors of them. So I know that they're going to be good. I just am curious about the sizing and if that's changed over the years. So let's go ahead and grab this pair and we'll talk a little bit about it. Here we have the Effortless leggings in their metal gray color and their black color. I got both of these leggings in the regular slash short length, and then I also got them in a size medium. In the past, I've learned to size up in these specific leggings. As I'm filming today, I'm showing that some of these colors, including this metal gray color, is 40% off, so that makes it $33. But normally these leggings retail for $55. There are lots and lots of colors and lengths and sizes in these leggings. So just check out their website if you're interested and see what colors that they have that intrigue you, and hopefully they'll have your exact size. Measuring the inseam for the short length, it is actually at about 25 inches. I'm not too sure what their long inseam is since I don't have it, and unfortunately they don't post their inseam measurements on their website, which I think is a little silly, but it is what it is. All they say is that if you're 5'7 and above, you should get the long, and of course 5'6 and below, you should get the short. I am 5'8" and I've got the short because in the past I did purchase one of their long leggings a long time ago and it was just too long. Like, it just didn't work. Obviously, just because you're 5'8" doesn't mean your legs are longer. It just depends on the proportions of your body. So I really feel like they should post their inseam measurements. I feel like that makes way more sense over just overall how tall are you, get this legging. And also, these leggings have a lot of vertical stretch, as most seamless leggings do. So honestly, most people would be okay with their regular length. If you are someone who knows you have long legs, then feel free to get the long version. I just can't tell you how long the inseam is. I digress. Anyway, let's get into the features here. So this legging is 52% polyamide and 37% polyester and 11% elastane. So slightly different material makeup. I would say the main feature of this legging is the scrunch in the back. It's just kind of what the Effortless is known for. It is an external scrunch, and when you're not wearing it, you can obviously see it. But in my experience, when you wear it, it definitely goes in between the cheeks cheeks and it's not very noticeable. Obviously everyone's anatomy is gonna slightly change those variables, but overall I've tried a lot of stretch leggings. This one's honestly right up there with Alphalete Amplifies leggings. Of course, it is Oner Active, so they have to have their contour seams, and you can see that here with the waist. This definitely helps make your waist look more snatched. In the back, you could see similar seams here that go around your glutes and just helps round the cheeks and make it very flattering, which we all love to see occasionally. Contour does go into a peak here, and you'll notice that this is all connected with that front contour here. It's a little hard to show, but for their crotch gusset, it is extended. It's not a triangle, so it does end kind of down here, and it's pretty small when you have it on, so you don't actually see it at all from the front, but it still does the job. I never ever have camel toe issues. I really like the waistband. It reminds me of Amplifies, except I believe it's only two tiered. Hopefully you can see the knitting up here is slightly different than the one down here, so two different tiers. This is all intended to help accentuate your waist, but also prevent gaping at the top. In terms of the fabric itself for this one, it's pretty solid, but there's just the slightest bit of marl. The black one just looks entirely solid, no marl to be seen there. On their website, they do say that this legging is not squat proof and you should wear a new thong underneath. Imagine the black one will be all good to go. All my Effortless leggings, I still wear them on leg days, but I will say that the material is very, very thin, so I always wear nude underwear underneath. But yeah, it just depends on what you're comfortable with. Just be aware that even on their website, they do not claim to be squat proof. Enough chit chat. Let's go ahead and put these leggings on, see what we think. All right, so we have the leggings on. They're actually not too big, thankfully, so definitely still size up if you're in between. So this is what it looks like in the front, and then this is what it looks like in the back. Very cute, very flattering. You can see the scrunch is doing its thing in between the cheeks, and you still have those contours on the side. I do have hip dips, so I find with Effortless, they are very thin leggings, so they do show that a little bit. Obviously, if you do like a darker color, you're not gonna see that as much. In this metal gray color, it's so light, you can really see everything. Most of the Effortless leggings are super cellulite friendly just because very solid colors, and they are also very, very thin, but very cute. Honestly, I am a fan. I've always thought Effortless was such a flattering legging. Again, these are their regular short version. I'm 5'8" and I find that they are totally acceptable lengths. There's so much vertical stretch, there's like literally no reason to get a tall for me. There is no front seam, so not too many issues with camel toes. And the only thing I would say about the medium and sizing up is I don't feel a lot of compression in the waistband. If I went down to a small, which is typically what I opt for with leggings, then that probably would be a lot better. But I do feel like there's a little bit of tightness in the glute area, and I don't have a lot of extra fabric. So personally, I'm just gonna stick with sizing up and deal with not having a lot of compression in the waist. I don't always love having a lot of compression up here anyway, but it is something I'm noticing as I'm like walking around. It's shifting just a little bit, not necessarily sliding down, but it just doesn't feel like as held in. With these leggings, I will not be doing a squat test because they are for sure not squat proof at all. When putting them on, whenever I stretch the fabric even a little bit, I could see my tattoo underneath. So anytime that happens, I know it's just not a safe legging for leg day. So no need to do a squat test here. I think the color is beautiful. Obviously lighter colors kind of add volume to your lower body. I think it's flattering, it's just not necessarily functional. Food for thought there. With that, let's throw on the black version. All right, so we have the black version on real quick. Very simple, very standard. Interestingly enough, the black version feels just slightly tighter than the gray. I think with Effortless, the darker the fabric, the tighter it may feel, so keep that in mind. Overall, I always recommend sizing up with their Effortless leggings. Always good to have a staple black legging. Obviously, you can't see too many details because it's black, but figured I would throw this on. And I do notice when I bend my knee and stretch the fabric, it does sheer up, but we'll go ahead and show you the squat test just to verify. But definitely this is more squat proof than that gray color. Of course, it is a black fabric, so it's gonna conceal more. It just comes with the territory. That is gonna conclude today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I know it was a quick one, but hopefully you got some helpful insight into Oner Active and some of these pieces. I'm looking forward to some of the content I have planned for the remainder of December as well as next year. Definitely going to incorporate a little bit more lifestyle and travel travel videos just to get some variety. Occasionally we'll do a fashion video, but I do feel like I have a little bit more passion for the travel side of things. And of course, I'll always have trips coming up to share. But if you like those types of videos or even videos like today, feel free to hit that subscribe button. I try to post every other week on either Sunday or Wednesday. If you'd like, you can also follow me on my Instagram or my TikTok because I do post much more frequently on those platforms. My TikTok and my Instagram is definitely more travel focused, but I do like to share kind of day-to-day life things on my Instagram. So if you can't get enough of me, feel free to follow those platforms. Otherwise, like the video if you liked it. It really does help push this channel to the right people. If you're a fellow girly who just likes these types of videos, please hit that like button. It definitely would be appreciated. Help a girl out. Other than that, I don't really have too much else to say. Just thanks for watching, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!